right, Steve, I got a question for you.
Sure.
So I talked a little bit before about Title IX stuff, and mm-hmm. I know that sometimes relates to ROTC cadets if they're either the perpetrator or the victim.
Yeah.
But we get some calls about ROTC disenrollment. Mm-hmm. What does that mean exactly?
Well, if you're a cadet in ROTC and you are what's called a contracted cadet, which mm-hmm. means you're either in your third or fourth year, or you're even in your first and second year, but you've accepted a scholarship.
Sure.
Then you are what's referred to as a contracted cadet. You've signed a contract for a service obligation.
Okay.
Okay. If you commit a violation, could be a violation of state law. If you act in a manner unbecoming of a future officer, Title IX would be a good example of
right.
either or both. The university can initiate formally what's called a disenrollment.
Okay.
In other words, you have some minimum due process in the ROTC department severing its relationship with you.
Basically, okay. you can respond to it, you can argue on your own behalf, stuff like that?
Well, there's a procedure
okay.
and regulations. Each service, the Army, the Air Force, is going to have internal regulations on how to conduct a disenrollment. There is, like I said, there's some due process, so you're allowed to present a defense mm-hmm. and you're allowed notice of the evidence that's going to be used against you.
Okay, well, mm-hmm. would you hire an attorney for something like that?
You can, and you probably should, because unlike people on active duty that are afforded child defense, you are not afforded free military representation for disenrollment. You're on your own.
Okay. So what happens if we get a call from a cadet mm-hmm. and they're going to be disenrolled, or they've been informed that there's something going on where they may have a hearing or something? What can we do for them exactly?
Well, we can discuss the case with them, first
sure.
of all, because I usually get two kinds of calls. I get the call... about half the calls I get are a cadet who says, I've just been tested for drugs mm-hmm. and I smoked. I did
right,
something.
Right.
I used a drug. I know I'm going to come back failing the drug test. And the other half of the calls are people who have already been notified
sure.
that separation or disenrollment has begun. First thing we can do is discuss with them generally what is the process and, you know, what are their rights.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, if they want to take it beyond that, we can represent them in the hearing.
And how do we represent them in the hearing? Because mm-hmm. my recollection is we can't actually participate in the hearing. We can prepare them for the hearing.
Yes, it's very unusual. It's similar to the way Title IX used to be,
sure.
but Title IX changed in the beginning of 2021.
Last year.
Yeah.
No, last year, actually.
2020,
yeah.
Okay. The military has not yet changed that. Military regulations are unique in this regard. You will go through a disenrollment as an ROTC cadet or a Service Academy cadet, mm-hmm. And you have to represent yourself, meaning that you have to question witnesses,
oh, wow.
you have to cross-examine witnesses, you have to make your arguments. Your attorney can be present mm-hmm. and can help you prepare for it, but cannot make those arguments for you.
That would be really intimidating without an attorney, though, without someone to even help you through the process to understand what kind of arguments should you make? What kind of questions should you ask?
I agree. I think it would be extremely difficult and very intimidating for someone to do that without even consulting with a lawyer.
Right.
Even with a lawyer who's prepared you, it's no easy task.
Of course.
Okay. Now, I'll tell you, I'll always remember it. One of the very first ROTC disenrollments I did was a cadet who was overweight. And the military has, you know, height and weight requirements, and he had habitually failed his weight. He was overweight.
Mm-hmm.
And they wanted to kick him out. And he did have some defenses, but the bottom line is he had to cross-examine the colonel who ran the ROTC department, and this was at Georgia Tech here mm-hmm. in Atlanta. And I will tell you that he cross-examined this colonel like a veteran attorney.
Wow.
This cadet listened to my advice, and he grasped the concept of how to cross-examine, how to ask leading questions that suggested the answers.
Sure.
His pace. He actually cross-examined better than some associates that worked for me at the time, which would have been
you.
Nah, I
don't think so.
He did well, and he won the case. Now, I'll also tell you that the hard and fast rule is the attorney who's present cannot talk.
Right.
A good attorney is going to push the edge of that envelope as much as you can get away with. I've done that on many occasions. Yeah.
So mm-hmm. your advice then would be if you are an ROTC cadet facing disenrollment or potentially facing disenrollment,
yeah.
depending on the circumstances, definitely give us a call and let's talk
yeah.
about it, because
absolutely.
It very well may save you. And it also may save right. you money, because some of these kids, the scholarship, mm-hmm. they ask for that money back, don't they?
Well, yeah. If you're on a scholarship as an ROTC cadet, I've had some cases where the cadet has accumulated over $120,000.
Sure.
in tuition that the mm-hmm. that the military's paid for. Some cases it's been less. I think the most I've ever had is about 120. And the military has options. They can disenroll you. Mm-hmm. They can disenroll you and send you on your way and not recoup
the tuition.
They can disenroll you and want their money back, and
right.
that's a federal debt, which means they're going to snatch every tax refund you ever get,
mm-hmm.
and they're going to come after you with
back.
That. Or, and this is important, or they can put you on active duty as an enlisted soldier for a period of time. So they can kick you out and recoup scholarship, or they can enlist you, okay? So the consequences are severe.
Mm-hmm.
Now, oftentimes I get people who call me and they say, you know, I did this, and I say, yeah, they've got you dead to rights.
Right.
And they cry about, well, they're going to recoup, you know, $80,000 in tuition. And my answer is, yeah, you basically just got a federal loan and you
right.
got to pay it back.
Right.
Sorry. So that is one possibility. But there are oftentimes defenses, and you can defend yourself. And, you know, sometimes you're going to lose, but sometimes your defenses will win. So we can talk about those maybe in a subsequent video.
Sounds like a plan.
All right. Shewmaker, ROTC and Service Academy disenrollments.